Oh. Feels like we wake up somewhere different every time, don't we?
I'm sorry about that. I can't let myself be captured this time. Oh no, is something wrong?
Grandpa, I cannot take you to the Netherworld. Will you be angry with me if I leave you here?
Oh my god, he's horrifying.
The Pooka's curse, huh? I'll never return to my human form. What in heavens has he done to me?
Beldor, you shall lead me to the Netherworld.
Fine, I don't care.
He sure likes to casually curse people, doesn't he?
Have no fear. I shall make sure that he does not escape.
You kind of think that somebody that gets stuck in a frog form would be less willing to just curse people willy-nilly in these permanent states.
Did you go to Titania? My cousin told me you did.
Anything particular I want? We can grab eggs and stuff if we want to. Actually, we have no money, basically. I'll grab I can't buy a fish fillet, actually. I was thinking maybe that. Let's just double check my inventory just to dump things. Oh yeah. Get a few of those out of the way. Ooh. More power generation. Actually kind of pointless because of the reload mechanic. Which I have gotten better awareness of now, because that was a problem for a while, was me not using it correctly. I think I knew it at the very beginning, and then in the middle chapters, because a little time passed in between, I kind of lost track of the mechanics' inner workings a little bit. Whoops! Also, people have pointed out exactly what's going on with the wizard thing, because it was a weird paradox I was trying to figure out. They are different wizards. Apparently that dragon must listen to different wizards. All three of the wise men, presumably? I was confused because I was trying to figure out the timeline of how that guy worked out, or like how he seemed to die two different ways, basically. Because functionally, story-wise, the wizard kind of dies by becoming a Pooka, in that he won't be that wizard anymore, at the very least, so then having him also die from the dragon was a little weird, but that's because they're two different wizards, they just look identical. Thanks a lot for that little bit of design, visually. I'm not bothering to give people different appearances. They're recolors of the same design, and as far as I can tell, they're the three wise men, and that's why there's multiple wizards that are recolors of each other, and sometimes when we see different people dealing with that one dragon, those are different wise men that are controlling him.
Thank you very much.
All right, good to go. Onwards. Oop. Whoops.
Your Majesty, I shall gladly fight to the death, with honor and pride for my country. But my paladin troops have succumbed to the Demon Lord's cipher. If I attack without a sound battle plan, it will be difficult.
Well then, you better start planning, buddy, or you're gonna die.
Ingwe? I'm so stupid. He's already a human. Ingwe.
I was gonna say, how could you think that was him? Also, wondering why there's so many frogs that seem to stand up, upright. Gonna freak me out, that's not how frogs work. Well, fantasy world, I suppose. Whoa, level 22. I'm like 9 or 10 ahead of that already?
We are now in the realm of the Queen of the Dead. This is the Netherworld. If this is all you want, let me go now.
Now do you understand how that dragon felt? I'll have you accompany me until we find Braum.
Melvin ordered me to bring him here. That is all. I know not where he is. Why not ask that spirit over there?
What? Would it respond to me? Can I ask a question? Do you know of Braum, the blacksmith who was brought here? Nothing.
Palace. The dwarf who designs jeweled weapons. The queen is keeping him there.
Thank you.
It seems Brahm is safe. Beldor? Well, I'm not frightened. I can do this alone.
How can I be in this shape? And strut around where the Holy are lurking? If they ever find me... Oh.
It seems that there have been many fools wandering the abyss of death lately. These cursed souls also enter the Queen's realm without fear.
And just like that, I believe we've seen two of the wise men die. One by dragon, one by underworld death minion dude. The same guy we saw claiming the Shadow Knight. Oops, missed that. My bad. Hi. How you guys feeling? Ooh, look at them go. I don't think we've seen the third one die. Admittedly, I didn't necessarily know right off the bat that they were the three wise men that all look the same. So I may have missed one of them without it registering, I mean. Where you going, buddy? I lose you guys? Nope. There we go. For the longest time, I was hitting square to skip and circle to exit, but I realized that hitting exit also skips, which I should have really put together faster, honestly. Onwards! Oh, hi. You guys feeling alright? Yep, there's that reload animation. Just gotta wait for a moment and your character goes, here we go, and then you get it reloaded. And everything's A-okay, and column rejointing for all. Seriously, it's in every goddamn game now. Oh, pots. Not pots. Definitely worse than pots. Just used to that icon meaning pots in many cases. There we go. Gimme, gimme. Oh, hi. And bye. Everything will work out fine, it's cool. You're just gonna be still dead. There's really no downside to this situation for you guys. It's probably why you're so happy to hassle random people. Not like you have anything to lose. There we go. This does mean I can use that one skill a little bit more fearlessly. This lasery one. Because I know that it's pretty easy to recover my ammo. Unfortunate that I'm gonna get especially used to this mechanic, and then it's gonna go away. I really hope that every subsequent character has some sort of interesting mechanic to manage. Are those a series of dead ends? They almost look like they might be. I don't see any paths leading out of this area. I hope the other characters have some sort of special thing going on with each one, just to keep the variety up. Because, hello? Oh, right. What am I doing there? Stupid. We can go ahead and bring that for one. There we go. There's a plant over here. So we have an exit, we have a store with a tiny chest. Hello! There we go. Should get planting while we're here. Yeah. Ooh, there's a skill and a chest down here. But yeah, I'm hopeful that each character has their own special mechanic from here on out, just because... the first two playthroughs were a little samey, in that the two of them kind of played like the same character, by and large. We have 19 for free. I have nothing else to supply unless I want to add my own. I'd prefer not to. Plant for me! Yeah. Because this has been nice, having a character that can fly and has a reload mechanic attached to their projectile-based attack. Probably why they put her in... If the other two are identical by comparison, this is probably why this one's in the middle of the campaigns of all places. To mix things up halfway through the game. My secret ingredient is now then. So we have five characters to play as, I think. Is it just five? Yeah, I want to say it's five total. And so it's natural to put them the most different one in the middle if you want to keep things paced well, I suppose. Hello, these are decently valuable. Turry cream stew. Let's get some of that going. And we're all out of every resource. Good. Good, good, good. We're encountering this guy pretty early in this level, so I'm gonna say we're probably a little low on resources for cooking. In which case, I'm probably just gonna leave and let this be this. That's really not really worth cooking, and there's nothing else available. Alright.
Thank you very much.
Just gonna save up for now. We'll encounter him elsewhere on the level sooner or later, that's usually how it goes. And since I know I'll encounter him later, I'll wait until then to think about using my money. Ow, pain. Oh god. Who's a nightmare? That's one of those stock sounds, by the way. It's interesting how often you can recognize stock sounds in video games and television once you start hearing them enough. This is a weird enough stock sound that I feel like I would have not recognized it otherwise. But I know it because they used it in Dark Souls 2. That little giggling sound they're making is the same sound that plays in Dark Souls 2 when you're nearby those, like, vases that curse you right around where you find those lion warriors later in the campaign. Hello. That was tragic. There we go. Oh. That didn't really work out either. There we go. That's where I'm picking it up from. One of the surprises for me at times is that, stock sounds actually can make their appearances in the, Oh, hello. What do we get? Banshee call. That's fitting enough. Summon a small spirit that fires ricocheting magic bullets for a time. Another summon, huh? Interesting. This one costs 13. Could be fun. I don't really have much to spend right now. Is there a 2-point thing to buy? More likely to knock away. Yeah, full pow knock away. The first blast of a. After reloading would be probably what that is most applicable to, but I think I'll save up for other stuff. Interestingly, I realized that stock sounds can even make appearances in the soundtracks of games, which surprised me. The first time I really picked up on that was the idea of that, like, the game Shadows of the Damned actually used the same audio library as Bastion. Bastion, with its iconic super... Nope. Salmon... Not even gonna try to pronounce that recipe. Alright. Just 3 different herbs and the fish. Not bad. Like, Bastion has this really well-known soundtrack that was award-winning and one of the most touted things about the game and so on and so forth. So it's surprising to me to notice that, like, you can hear the exact... You can see that there's all these samples involved in the audio in its soundtrack. Because that game seems like it almost sounds like a bunch of stuff that was being performed, but of course it's a small indie studio, so of course there are samples and stuff like that. So there's a weird 2D sequence in Shadows of the Damned where the exact, like, super tense string section sound plays in that game that played in Bastion during the escape sequence near the beginning of the game, where you're running away and there's a fast string section panicking. I'm like, well, this is surreal, hearing the exact same audio in 2 different games in the soundtrack. Hello. You just killed that wizard. I should really be thanking you, honestly, because that guy was awful. You gave me a nice moral way to get that character killed. Yay! I think that's literally the reason why that happens, by the way, in video games and movies and stuff like that. On a regular basis, we want to conveniently write a storyline where the bad guy gets what's coming to them, because they deserve it. But we don't want to tarnish our poor heroes by making them kill somebody. So what we do is we just have them conveniently get killed by something else, either some sort of sudden tragic accident or some other bad thing catches up with them. Or oftentimes they get themselves killed via greed or whatnot. Conveniently, right after they've played their part in the story, they just happen to get themselves killed. Aha! That's kind of what happened here, as he wanders off through his cowardice, abandoning Mercedes to her own devices, and immediately gets killed, as it goes. This guy really likes his piles of corpses to destroy. Oh, nope, duck. I thought it was gonna go over my head, so I just figured I'd duck under it. Ow, my life is pain. All right, he likes to dodge. I see how it is. Oh, hey, how you doing? Oh, wow, he attacked backwards. Of all directions to go in, that was not the one I was expecting. Here we go. Aha. Ow. All right, I should probably do something about that. We'll all be better. Eh, we're healthier at least. Marginally better. Oh, there he goes. There he goes! There he goes! I can't help but eventually poke fun at it when somebody... When a game insists on having somebody vocalize every time a certain action happens. The worst recent case of this was, Anima. A game where every single time I did this, every time there was this one attack I like to use, and every single time I ever used it, my character would go, "This is the end! This is the end! This is the end!" And I'm like, it really becomes disingenuous when you hear them say it more than once. It's kind of like calling your. It'd be like as if my attack was called Final Fantasy 15. It's like, I don't think the final part's so genuine anymore. This is the end! It's also especially great when a boss... Oh! Cocoon! Nightmare. I was trying to fly over that on purpose, honestly. Messed that up. Oh, weird. It's really weird seeing how it shrinks like that. Yeah. Okay, calm down, dude. I just want to finish you off. Oh, my energy's out. Stopping to reload is becoming a little bit of a hassle. Oh, you son of a bitch. Oh, we're not getting a good score on this one. Oh. I'm starting to think that attack might not be as worth it as I was hoping. Maybe I should stop using that laser. It seems like it might be way less efficient than just attacking with normal attacks. Let's see here. Kind of want to remap something. Let's see. Right, that's the explosion attack. Let's remap the new attack over that. Banshee Call. Yeah. Over Foes on Burst. Don't have the PP for it right now. We'll work on it. Thank you. New checkpoint unlocked. We got a key that takes us to the boss, but of course we have to unlock things along the way. Presumably if I go around here, it'll loop back around. Otherwise I would have questions about what's going on here. Let's go ahead and just eat this. No. Let's use my nice healing potions instead. The food could still be used for other reasons. And I like my experience. I'm rather amused by being ahead of the curve with other stuff. Thank you. Let's try that attack. So you shoot a bouncing attack, apparently. Oh, I guess it only happens when there's enemies nearby. I thought it would just randomly shoot a bouncing attack in every direction. Shoot him! Oh, that's what you meant by bouncing. Interesting. It does a ground-based attack. Didn't really expect that. Didn't really seem to attack very much either. Not entirely sure if that one was worth it. Oh! Ow, rude. Got him. Got them. That was a quick one. That one was almost weirdly quick. Got new recipes for the pile, at least. Unseeable. Makes the user invisible. And unable to interact with the world. Used for safe travel. 3 bones, cores, or stems. Probably won't ever use that one. Not unless I'm in a super lethal situation where I'm super close to dying, but even then, I better have a really good goal in mind. Hey, everyone. Oh. Being all invulnerable for the moment? No, you're nice and vulnerable now. Come here, little guy. No escape. Oh no, she loved me and it hurt. It hurt like only like real love can. Leave me alone. Just go evil already, you're annoying me. Where's Candle Spirit friend? There's no candle spirit, friend? But they need to die. They can't be allowed to live. Am I forgetting the trick to fighting these guys? Oh, there we go. You walk right into them and they freak out. There we go. Hug me! Where you at? Hug me. Oh. Hug me. Thanks for making me wait for it, though. That was extra exciting when that happened. On we go. Are you sure you're ready for this ultra difficult boss? Yeah, probably. Maybe. If I lose, I'll just restart the room, right? Aha! Go, little spirit friend. Don't screw me by not attacking. You better attack a lot. Yeah, you do those wimpy little those wimpy bounce attacks. Whoa, that is the most Beetlejuice of attacks. I think I said that. I probably said that last time. But those are straight up purple tentacles. It's fitting. They don't seem very nice at all. Oh, that's bad. Excuse me. Coming through. I just slid straight through the floor stuff. That's probably a bad call on my part. What are you doing over there? Yeah, excuse me. I'm gonna destroy all your floating weird things for a second. Not a fan, to be honest. Oh, here we go. Please go down? Please? Pretty please. With like sugar plums and stuff? No? None of that? I'm gonna go over here for a second. Feeling a tad under the weather. Thank you. Ow. Did that spirit even help? I feel like it didn't really help me at all. It's a very disingenuous defensive spirit. There we go. Just keep reloading. We'll be good. Oh, man. This guy's he's here to have a good time. Excuse me. No, thank you. I will not be accepting any applications at this time. If you could wander on off, please. There we go. Oh, where'd he go? Oh, he disappeared. Well, that makes that attack significantly less effective, as it turns out. Come on, floating flurry. Just rip into him a bit. It's fine. They'll learn to appreciate when they're older. I say about the immortal being. Okay. There's a lot of danger around here for people like me, isn't there? Hey, little carrot. You're mine. Do you like being mine? I like you being mine. They are not quick to damage at the moment, are they? Ow, ow, ow. What are those nightmare weapons? Oh, they're trying to attack still. They're consistent. If nothing else. Oh, well, I didn't even hit him. Good job, me. Good job. Do I even have another heal yet? Yeah, I do. Should probably craft one right now, actually. Really no reason to have that many in there. And those kinds of additions also cause problems. That's one way to make it more powerful. Yeah, just spend all of our food. Haha! I'll spend grapes. There we go. We got a good follow-up. If you could just politely die, please. I've got a lot of these up now. I've got a backlog. Oh, they went away. There we go. There we go. There we go. Full power energy attacks. Now there's a lot less attacks gonna be coming my way. Ow, ow, ow. Oh, the floor looks like it's dangerous all of a sudden. I'm trying to get out of that. Where are you going? You leaving me? But if you leave me now, you take away the greatest part of me. I was about to say he's bullet spongy, and then I realized that I'm literally playing as a character that has bullet-type attacks now, which makes that kind of relatively common thing for me to say a bit more apt than usual. He is a durable one. Ow. Where you going? There you are. Don't mind me just destroying your tentacles for the sake of your power. Yay! That's the best way to get foes off in this fight, for sure. Where are you going? There you are. There you were. Haha! Still got an S rank. I guess the fight was just supposed to be that long. There we go. That was a terrible place to spawn a chest, by the way. What if we just dip it, like, you know, in the poison? I think they'll appreciate that, really. Like, as a player base in general, they'll be pretty psyched that we did that. Signed, audience, designers. But this was a dead end. Go back that way and we'll find some items, though. Sure. There's also a rest stop in that direction. Alright. Definitely a little tempted to go elsewhere just for the sake of the, maybe getting some bonus storage. Yeah, maybe I will go back that way. Not much of a time sink to just go through two rooms real quick. Here we go. Ow, poison. I was looking at the map. Oh. Almost walked into that one again. Gotcha.